Okay, guys, look at this. Dear Benjamin, I am writing to regard to your inquiry about a video of our online admissions test and a video you have recently uploaded to YouTube. Please note that the test is the property of the Department of blah 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 blah. Please note that the disclosure of questions is not allowed. Blah 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 blah. I may request you to remove from your video all screenshots, videos, and other evidence of the test, and remove all reference to any questions. Oops. Hey guys, so today we're going to be talking about the Imperial College admissions test for computer science. I'll be going over everything you need to know about it, so make sure you watch to the end of the video so you can get the full spectrum of what's going on. So what is the Imperial College admissions test? This computing admissions test is basically there for the college, Imperial College, to have a sense of how much of a fit you are for their course, and it tests your academic ability. It's actually a compulsory test for every computing admissions applicant. On the website, it's a really small piece of, it's in the how to apply section of their website, and it's really hard to find, so I couldn't find it for ages, but thankfully they emailed me saying I had to do this test, and also because I knew about the test just from other people doing it. I think that this test is used for them to weed out the, like, because I reckon there'll be like maybe 30% of people who just aren't going to have any chance of getting in, and this test just differentiates those people from the people who should get interviewed and should have a chance of getting it. The test tests your logical and problem solving and critical thinking skills. There's 10 multiple choice questions, each of which are just logical questions, which are all quite fun and quite, it's the type of questions that you see in those like logic games. And I'll be going over some examples later, so don't worry. The test is 45 minutes long, but they tell you to take out 90 minutes of your time for it, because there's also a practice section. So there are two tests. There is the practice test and the proper admissions test. Now, the practice test isn't actually a test. It's more of just, you know, those information tutorials that you get before some, you know, websites or some tests. That's essentially what that is. It's just seeing if your computer can handle their interface. Actually, there is one actual question in the practice test. There's one question about, like, I don't know, there's just a practice question there, just to get you familiar with what could be on the exam. And then after you complete the practice test, there will be like a 5 or 10 minute delay. But then after that, if you refresh your page, the proper admissions test should come up on your portal. And then you have timed 45 minutes to complete that test. A day or like maybe a few days before they want you to do the test, Imperial College will send you an email saying the details of when you're going to take the test, what it is, you know, just some basic information. I'll put the email in here actually for you guys to see. At 10 a.m. they send you like the email with your online access forms and like whatnot, just to get you onto their admissions portal. And then from there you can just kind of spend the whole day whenever you want in that day just doing the test. But I just did it in the morning of the day just to get it over and done with. Can you reschedule your time? Yes, you can, because I actually had my driving theory test on the day that they originally wanted me to do it. So I just sent them a quick email to good old Hannah, and she was just like, yeah, sure, we'll rearrange it for you. So there's no stress there, you know, they don't mind at all. Now, what is in this test? So as I said, it's assessing your logical and problem solving skills, reasoning skills. I didn't actually prepare for this test because just from talking to people, I knew that the test wasn't going to be as hard as the TMUA, and I previously had done the TMUA, so I had prepared like weeks for that. So I just knew that I was, you know, I was set for this test. I had already pretty much done with the preparation I needed to do, and I think I was more or less right. I think in hindsight, I should have probably spent a day just refreshing my mind on, you know, problem solving skills. But if you guys are thinking about how you should prepare for the admissions test, I would recommend you guys to actually have a look at TMUA section 2, because those are the questions that were really similar in this test and the TMUA. In fact, I'm gonna put up some questions now for you guys to do if you want to. And make sure you skip this bit if you're taking the TMUA, because these are straight from TMUA paper 2. Honestly, the test wasn't as stressful as I thought. It wasn't as, you know, time pressuring as other tests that I've done before. And honestly, just for some final tips, don't worry, don't stress about it. If you don't enjoy the test, I mean, it probably just shows that you won't enjoy it going to an Imperial as well, because from what I've heard, the Imperial College Computing is so difficult. It's like they push you so hard in the course. So that being said, I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope this was helpful. Make sure to like and subscribe for some more videos. Thank you.